Dr. Borchardt, and this is your Marijuana Money Minute. There's just one more week until our first psychedelic investing event here in New York City. After that, our next cannabis conference will be also in New York City, and it's on April 3rd. You can get all the information at www.greenmarketsummit.com. GW Pharmaceuticals said this week that it expects total net product sales to be about $108 million for the fourth quarter and roughly $309 million for the year ending in December. The bulk of those fourth quarter sales comes from its epileptic drug, Epidiolex. Those are expected to be about $104 million for the fourth quarter and about $296 million for the full year. Organigram Holdings reported that its first quarter 2020 revenue rose by 102% over last year to $25 million. That beat analyst estimates by $10.24 million. The company cautioned, though, that it's pumping the brakes on cultivation as Canada is moving at a much slower pace on its store openings. Aphria reported revenue for its adult-use cannabis. They said it increased 46% sequentially to $29 million. Now their total net revenue decreased sequentially by 4% to $120.6 million. But it did jump 457% over last year's second quarter. They did deliver a net loss of $7.9 million. This week, High Times announced that it was getting into the dispensary business. The company has plans for two flagship locations in Las Vegas and Los Angeles. And in addition to that, High Times named Paul Henderson as their new CFO. Now, this will be their third CFO for the company in just 1 year. Manifest 7, formerly known as MJIC, has acquired the San Francisco-based cannabis delivery company, Lady Chatterley Health. They are focused on high-end women's products for an undisclosed amount. Rogue Station Companies has acquired Brahma LLC. They are also known as Terp Extractors. They are based in Colorado, and they are a processing company. And Carlos Santana announced his partnership with Left Coast Ventures to develop premium cannabis and hemp CBD products. And finally, Cultivar Holdings said its shares have been listed on the CSE using the symbol CULT. And that's it for this week. I'm Deborah Borchardt reporting for the Green Market Report from a very windy Times Square.